Hello and welcome to this episode of Sip and Sync with Azure. In this one, we're talking about AI agents and how to build them in a no-code fashion. And I've got here from our product team, Rohitha. Welcome to the show.
Thank you. Thank you for having me. It's great to be here.
Awesome. Well, tell us a little bit about what do you do at Microsoft?
Yeah, I'm an engineering manager with Azure Logic Apps, and which has been an integration platform for over a decade now. We have been in this business.
Yeah.
And with agentic AI now, we are evolving the platform to be more agentic and make things super simple for users.
And so you're working on something, you just oversimplified it, but let me tell you, the product is extremely amazing. You're working on something that is allowing people to build drag and drop AI agents without writing any code. And I think that is extremely powerful. Exactly. How are you doing that?
Exactly. So we are a platform, a low-code, no-code platform in the integration business. And we have built over 1,400 connectors from past services in Azure to SaaS services like Microsoft Office, ServiceNow, third-party services, and legacy systems like IBM mainframes. And that means we take care of handling different authentications and then taking care of different protocol details, different interaction patterns. As a developer, you just pick the connector and we take care of the plumbing.
And the connectors that you're talking about, these are the real connectors where an enterprise application comes together, right? So when we're thinking about AI agents, one of the biggest complexities of building an AI agent is actually not the AI part, right?
No. The biggest complexity I have seen customers running into is running these agents in the system that they're already running.
Exactly.
And what that means is handling different authentication schemes and taking care of data governance, yeah, and compliance, and then navigating different network security boundaries. So that's, yeah, very hard problem to solve.
Hard problem to solve. And you're doing that in a visual way without using much of code, but all these connectors. Why don't we see it?
Exactly.
Great.
So let me show you what I got here. This is an agentic chatbot that I have built for a fictitious coffee retailer. We call it Fourth Coffee. And they have built it for their account managers. And account managers use it to get information about the customers that they are managing. So why don't I show it here? For people who are familiar with Logic App, this is the familiar Logic App designer, and all you do is drag and drop here. Mm-hmm. And for people who need to write code, you can write code too. And this is an agent, as you can see here, if I click on the agent, you can see this is using GPT-4.1 model. And if I scroll down a bit, you can see the prompt, the system instructions. And this has been given a bunch of tools, and these are all drag and drop from a library of connectors that we have. Yeah. And the first one is a AI search connector, and it gives this agent access to a knowledge base that we have built, collecting all the data about the customers from support cases to orders and so on. And then I have already also given it access to a ServiceNow account, the incident management system for Fourth Coffee, and access to Microsoft Teams. So these use different authentication schemes.
So I've got a question there. So when we talk about AI agents, I would say three components to it. There's the tools component, which is what you just talked about, the integration with your embeddings, the search, mm-hmm, and then the integration here with your ServiceNow and all these other sources like Teams and so. But there's the second component, which is your memory as well and the data. Mm-hmm. How are we handling some of that in this?
So as a developer, you have multiple options to choose.
Yep.
Again, it's configuration. You don't have to write code. We have short-term memory option and long-term memory options. As a user, you pick what you want.
Okay, great. All right, so keep going. Let's see one of the tools.
So this is a conversational agent. You get a built-in chat client.
Yeah.
So if I click on here, so let's see this in action. You get this link here to a chat client, which is already built in, and you and your users are ready to get started as soon as the agent is built.
Mm-hmm.
And if I click in here, you get to, and this chat client, by the way, is embeddable into your own website as an iframe. Mm-hmm. and it signs you in based on the auth configuration you have set on your app. And in this case, I logged in. It's configured to for the Microsoft tenant, so it lets me log in. And now you're ready to chat with your agent. So in this case, I'm going to be the account manager, and one of my customers, Contoso Cafe, has an order that's getting delayed, and they have opened a support ticket, so they have escalated to me to see if I can help. So I'm going to simply ask the chat and see if it can get me the details about it. And what's going to happen now is it's going to talk to the AI search knowledge base and see if we can find any information about what's going on. So okay, as you can see, it was able to locate the support ticket, and it looks like this is an order that's exceeding the credit limit. So the risk department is putting a hold. So I'm going to go in and ask, see if I can create an incident on this, on the risk team, to see if they can help out. Okay, so there's a typo. Let me fix that.
Maybe it will fix it on its own.
Yeah. Right? All right. So now what's going to happen is it's going to invoke the ServiceNow connector. Remember, we have that connector in there.
Yep.
And so I have the incident number. So I'm going to actually also send a notification to the risk team that I opened this ticket so they can take a look at this. So,
and that's through Teams connector.
That's through Teams connector. See, like we on that. So now, so I'm going to say, can you send a notification to the risk department here? So I'm expecting it to now, as you can see, it popped me off to authenticate because I have configured Teams with the saying, hey, like you need to invoke the Teams connector in my permission context. So I need to sign in here and let the agent talk to Teams on my behalf. So I got that out. So now I'm expecting it will call Teams, and so already call Teams, and then I can actually click here and see in Teams. There you go.
There's a notification.
Notification I did with my own account.
That's awesome. Can we go back to the screen again where we saw the architecture or what's going on?
So now one other thing you can do is if you go back as a developer and an operator of this agent, I want to know like if something goes wrong.
Exactly. That's where I was going.
Yeah.
Because so, things go wrong.
Exactly. So now if I go to here, I have the full list of the conversation that Steam is having with my users. And you can go here and take a look at all the conversation being exchanged. And for example, in this particular one, I can see all the message exchanges that happen. Not only that, you can see the tools that got invoked in the, for example, here. Let's take a look at the one that it did with the so ServiceNow here. If I click on this link. Okay, let's see if we can get to this one here.
Incident. Yeah, this
one. Yeah, so there it is.
Yeah. You've got that.
Oh, there it is. So create record. And I can, if I click on here, I can see actual input, output. If there was an error, tool failure, you can see all of that in the monitoring we built into your agent itself.
Full transparency. So where I see value of this is for enterprises that have maybe smaller teams or teams that are just getting started with AI agents. You can start off with no-code, low-code experience like this, still get all the visibility and the troubleshooting aspects of building. And then when they are ready to even like take this further and maybe become pro-code, make this application pro-code eventually, they can do that for
you. Yeah, lots of extensibility points built into Logic Apps. You can bring your own code. We let people write code in multiple different languages, C#, JavaScript, and we recently started supporting Python. So when you hit a wall, that's not a dead end. You can fall back. And
that's the challenge with no-code, low-code applications. Like if you suddenly want to do something that's not supported, let's say, then most enterprises want that extensibility aspect, and it's good that that provides that. But anything else you want to cover?
So I think Logic App with the setup connectivity bringing and so far the challenge, most time consuming part for many of our developers has been putting this logic together.
Mm.
We give the connectors, drag and drop, but yeah. still they had to implement the logic of automating business processes.
Right.
But with agentic AI, that needs goes away.
Mm.
So all of that logic can now become a simple prompt.
Yeah.
And you throw in the right set of tools and things just work.
Yeah.
So with the new capabilities we have built in, like you get all the connectivity mm-hmm. and now we have taken out the need for doing all this complex logic. Leave it to the AI.
Right, exactly. And so are you able to create this flow without actually dragging and dropping or?
No, it is all drag and drop. And the other part is we also do support like handling multi-agent orchestration. The Logic App is an orchestration platform
yeah.
by itself. So there are lots of built-in available orchestration patterns for like doing fan out, fan in, branching. So all of that now you can combine with the agents.
You've got
multiple agents interacting with each other in numerous ways.
Yeah, you can create, we just saw a single agent application mm-hmm. with a bunch of tools, but you can imagine a multi-agent application with it as well. Awesome. That was great. Thank you for walking me through that demo. I'm sure you all enjoyed it too. And if you are on this journey of building AI agents and don't know where to begin, this sounds like the perfect spot to be in. We'll put the links in the description below for you to get started, and I'll see you next time.